with the latest films in cinema being released in 3D and now are in 3D channel, the question isn't just how do you film 3D, but the question now is how do you film good 3D?
Let's take a look at how 3D works. 3D works by shooting the same scene from two different angles, approximately 2.5 inches apart, to represent distance between our eyes. When combined, the two images make a complete stereoscopic 3D image that can be fused together with our eyes. 3D is broadcast in side by side or in over under format. For side by side, this halves the horizontal resolution of the image. However, when the image is combined, our eyes see a 1080i HD image. Over under is the same, although this time the vertical resolution is halved. Let's take a look at convergence. Convergence is the point that both images meet. When shot parallel, 100% of the image appears in front of the screen. If you converge on the ball, it appears on the screen plane. If we converge in front of the objects, they appear behind the screen. We're going to experiment with the convergence point now. At the moment, the convergence point is set on myself, so the ball appears at the front of the shot, almost coming out of the screen. The ball has now been set to convergence point, and it's now on the plane, and I appear much further back in the shot. The final convergence point we tried is just behind me, so now both myself and the ball appear in front of the plane. Here's an example of a shot that's not too great quality and should actually be used with 2D cinema rather than 3D. This wider shot is much more acceptable. This even wider shot is also acceptable. It's much better than the first image, which is a closer shot, didn't allow the depth to create true 3D. When the focal length of the two images isn't synchronised, you can see some real issues with object movement, as you can see in the ball right now. Also, if zoom mismatch is an issue, then this happens. Now here's what it should look like with the zoom properly synchronised.
Edge violation is one of the main causes of 3D sickness. As you can see with the tree on the left of our image, because it's on the edge, it's only visible through one of our eyes, and this means that we can't combine two images to make it 3D. This is commonly seen in quite a few football matches where you get crowd shots and you just get like an arm, something comes poking out, and because it's on the edge, only one of the cameras can see it, and you don't get the full 3D effect of that object.
As the image in the top right corner shows, there is a difference in brightness and colour between the left and right image. This is uncomfortable for the viewer, but can easily be corrected in post-production like this. Much better. As you can see in the image in the top right corner, the lenses are not perfectly aligned. This can easily be corrected in post-production by adjusting the position of the left and right image. Here is what it should look like.
So here's some examples of how you might film an interview in 3D.
Interviews should be shot very differently in 3D, making sure they are wider to give a greater sense of depth. In 3D, we don't get much depth from a close-up, so it is best avoided. One final thing, when editing in 3D, be careful not to cut between shots too quickly to allow the viewer to take in the image. As you can see, this would drive you mad if 3D was cut like this, so don't do it.
So there you have it, that's how you film some great 3D.